break bread together.
Thank you very much. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for tuning in to Lessons from the Bible this morning. And we want you to know that we appreciate it and hope that the lessons that we have will be an encouragement and edifying to each and every one. If you have any questions concerning anything that we might say, we want you to feel free to let us know. And you can do that by giving us a call at 216-5856. Let me invite you to the services of the Lucas Street Church of Christ. Their worship service begins at 10 o'clock on Sunday morning, and they are situated where you can either go into the building if you like, or you can sit in your vehicle and tune in to 101.9, and you can listen to the lesson there, and they will come out and give you the Lord's Supper and give you an opportunity to give as well. I would like for you to come and be with us at the Swancott Church of Christ. Our worship service began at 11 o'clock on Sunday mornings, and we also have Bible study on Wednesday night at 7 o'clock. So if you're in the area, come and be with us and study God's Word with us there at the Swancott Church of Christ. We would love to have you. We have been studying salvation, and we have been looking at the purpose of salvation, and we made the point that the purpose of salvation was to redeem mankind. That was God's whole purpose, was to redeem mankind back to Himself. We also looked at the place of salvation, and we made the point that salvation is in Christ. So in order for us to have salvation, then we must be in Christ. And so this morning, I want us to pick up with the fact of the plan of salvation. And we left off making the point that the plan of salvation, one of the things that one must do is the fact that he must be willing to hear God's word. And just simply hearing God's word is not enough. We must hear with the intent or with the view toward being obedient to the word of God. Jesus said in Matthew chapter 7, verses 24 through 27, "Therefore whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man, which built his house upon the rock. The rain descended, the floods came, the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell not." Why? Because it was founded upon a rock. "And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them not shall be likened unto a foolish man which built his house upon the sand. The rains descended, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell. And great was the fall thereof." And so here we can see that it is very important that we not just hear God's word, but we must be willing to obey God's word as well. Also, when it comes to the plan of salvation, not only must we hear the word of God, but we must be willing to believe the word of God. Now, does belief, does that merely mean that we just, you know, just hear with the intent not to obey? No. Believing, my friend, in Christ is more than just simply, well, I've heard what he says, I know what it says, but we also must be willing to not just hear and not just believe, but we also must be willing to obey God's word. Believing is terribly important. It is the foundation upon which salvation is laid. John said in John chapter 3 and verse 16 and 17, it says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." So belief in Christ is mandatory. If we want to be saved, we must believe. We don't have a choice. It either believe in the Lord, or you're lost. Notice what the Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter 11, in verse number 6. For without faith, listen, for without faith, it is impossible to please him. For he that cometh to him must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. So, belief in God is mandatory. But belief does not put one into Christ. And I'm afraid that there are a lot of people that believe in the Lord, but they're not willing to obey the Lord. And just because you, me, or anyone else might believe, that does not put us into Jesus Christ. Romans chapter 10 and verse 10 says, for with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, but with the mouth salvation is made unto salvation. So, with the heart man believe what? Unto righteousness. That is, he's going forward. He's moving toward. Romans chapter 1 and verse 16 says, The power of the Lord, my friend, God's power is to save, is in the gospel, the plan of salvation. And let us never forget that. God's power to save is in salvation, is in the gospel. To everyone that what? Believeth. You have to believe in order to be saved. Some believe yet are lost. James tells us that in the book of James chapter 2 and verse 19. James said that the devils believe and tremble. Now let me ask you a question. Are the devils lost? Are the devils going to be saved? You might say, well, no. But yet the Bible says what? They believe. And not only did they believe, but they also tremble. There were some Pharisees who believed but would not repent and confess. In the book of John chapter 12 and verse 42, it says, nevertheless, many of the chief rulers also believe on him. But because of the Pharisees, they did not confess him, lest they should be put out of the synagogue. For they love the praise of men more than the praise of God. So believing alone, it's not enough. We must change our ways and repent as well. Now, repentance. Does repentance get us into Christ? Well, repentance is mandatory for salvation. But repentance does not get us into Christ. Matter of fact, the Bible tells in the book of Luke chapter 13 and verse 3, I tell you nay, but except you repent, you shall all likewise perish. God commanded all men everywhere to repent. In Acts chapter 17 and verse 30, there the Bible tells us, in the times of this ignorant God winked at, but now commanded all men everywhere to repent. Repenting is necessary to avoid eternal, my friend, eternal perishing. And 2 Peter chapter 2 and verse number 9, it says, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering to us, what, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Isn't it wonderful to know that God don't want anyone to perish? But if we are not willing to repent, that is exactly what is going to happen to us. Either we repent or we perish. But repentance does not bring one in to Christ. In Acts chapter 11 and verse 18, it says, when they heard these things, they held their peace and glorified God, saying, Then has God also to the Gentiles granted repentance unto life. In Acts chapter 19, in verse number 4, contains an account of some who repented, but they were not baptized correctly. So repentance, my friend, is important. It is necessary. It is something that one must do. But repentance does not get us into Christ. Like belief and like hearing and belief, repentance is getting us toward Christ. But not only does one have to repent, but also confession. But does confession get us into Christ? Well, confession is necessary in order to be saved. There's no doubt about that. Because of what Jesus said in the book of Matthew chapter 10 and verse number 32 and 33. Everyone therefore who shall confess me before men, him will I confess before my Father which is in heaven. But whosoever shall deny me before men, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. Confession is unto salvation. Romans chapter 10 and verse 10. For with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. So confession is unto salvation. But let's quickly look at what gets us into Christ. And that is, and many folks deny it, but it is baptism that put us into Christ where we need to be. Well, does baptism get us into Christ? And the answer is absolutely. We are baptized into the one body, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 12 through 13. For as the body is one, and has many members, and all members of that one body, being many, are one body. So also is Christ. For by one Spirit are we all baptized into one body. Whether we be Jew or Greek, whether we be born or free, we have all been made to drink of one Spirit, and that is of the Lord. When we are baptized into Christ, we put on Christ. Galatians chapter 3, verses 27 through 29. For as many of you as been baptized into Christ have put on Christ. There is neither Jew or Greek, neither bond nor free, there is neither male nor female, for ye are all one in Christ Jesus. If ye be Christ, then are you Abraham's seed indeed. When we are baptized, we are baptized into Jesus Christ. So my friend, I see that my time is gone, and I hope that we can see that hearing is important. It is very important, but it doesn't get us into Christ. Believing doesn't get us into Christ. Repentance doesn't get us into Christ. Confession doesn't get us into Christ. But according to God's word, it is baptism that puts us into Christ where we need to be. And if you have not been baptized, let me encourage you to do that today. And if I can help and assist you in any way, then please let me know. I see that my time is gone, and I appreciate you for yours. Until next time, we bid you a pleasant good day.
Let us break bread together on our knees.
Yes.
Let us break bread together on our knees.
Uh-huh.